Hi, I'm Pete Scargill, and this is a video being made with the Samsung Galaxy Android camera. It's a great camera. It has features that take it way above anything you can achieve with the mobile phones, but it also has a couple of limitations, and I'm going to try and get you by one of them right now. The camera has an internal microphone. You would expect that you could plug an external microphone into the lead that's reserved for headphones. Well, you can, but not quite as you might imagine. The problem comes when you try and plug an external microphone in. It won't work. The connectors, you'll see one here. I'll just take this out of the pack for you. There's a typical connection that's got four connections, the tip, and then two connections there and the outer shell. So if you're into electronics at all, you would expect the outer shell to be the ground, and then the microphone, and then the two stereo, the tip and the next one down would be the two stereo outputs for headphones. Well, that's wrong in this case. They don't use the outer shell as the ground. They use that third pin as the ground. So your standard connector, not going to work. They use the microphone connection for two things. If it's a very low value, typical impedance of a normal microphone, it actually acts not as a mic, but as a switch. It's for taking pictures, like a remote control. So the way around it is to use that pin there, the first one in, as the ground, and then the shell as the input to the microphone, so you don't want a metal shielded 3.5mm connector. You want the plastic shielded one. So that's fine. So you can put the microphone with a 1K series resistor. What you'll probably find, though, is that series resistor will allow the microphone to work, but it'll drop its level down and drop the quality a little bit. It all depends on the mic. The type I'm using here is a Maplin's clip mic, type with a little battery in it. Okay, so, and that's fine. That's an EM400 from Maplin's. Quite cheap. Fits on the collar there. The problem with that is, you know, why would you want an external mic if the quality is going to be worse? If I move away from the camera here, you'll find that my voice gets more and more hollow. That's just the way microphones tend to be. So you want to be close up to the mic. Now, if you're going to interview somebody, or you're going to be wandering around, so the internal mic's not a good idea. Plus, you're holding on to the camera and touching it, and that's going to produce noise. So what you really want is an external mic. So there is some advice on the web about using this 1K resistor in series with the lead in the middle, and I've put some photographs here to show you what I did. Simple solution that I've not seen yet is to put a capacitor in series across the resistor so that the AC, the voice signal, gets through but not a DC current. Here's the finished product. I hope you can do a better job than I've done. So there's your lead plugs into the camera, and a little plastic box there, just a little potting box that contains the capacitor and the resistor. So maybe you could come up with something in line that looked a bit better than that. But that's basically it. I'm now going to show you with the external mic connected. And so as you can see, I now have the external mic connected. The sound's clearer because I'm nearer to the microphone. I'm going to move away, and as you see, it makes absolutely no difference. No noise pickup, despite the fact that I'm using something like a 3-meter lead. You could probably run a considerably longer lead. And that's it. So if you get the same mic and follow the instructions, or a similar mic anyway, you should now have a semi-professional sound quality on your Samsung Galaxy Android camera.